are synthetic inorganic chemists, and we work mostly with colloidal semiconductors, but also other materials, including some intermetallics, for example. So we typically try to develop the synthesis of an interesting material in solution phase, usually as small nanocrystals. And typically these are projects that are motivated by some particular application. So for example, many of the compounds or materials that we work with are of interest for solar energy conversion and other energy conversion applications. So my students become well versed on synthetic inorganic chemistry, both on the molecular side as well as the material or bulk side. So we use techniques such as vacuum or Schlenk lines as well as glove boxes to conduct all of our syntheses. Also some high temperature furnaces, for example. And then in terms of characterization, we routinely use things like powder X-ray diffraction, solution phase NMR of proton and other nuclei, a lot of optical spectroscopy, both absorption and photoluminescence or fluorescence spectroscopy as well, infrared among other techniques. On the non-laboratory side of things, so of course communication is key. All of my students write their own papers, they prepare their own drafts, and we work together in editing those drafts. I think that's extremely important. We encourage all of our students to go to conferences and to give at least one talk and at least one poster at national conferences like the American Chemical Society National Meeting, sometimes a global conference. We also emphasize a lot teamwork. So students are expected to work in pairs or in multiple people teams to complete a project, oftentimes in collaboration with other groups. Collaborations are awesome. So I think we're very good at the things that we do, but we cannot know everything, right? Nobody knows everything. So we often partner with people that are experts in their field so that we can work together. So if our expertise is here and their expertise is here, we can hopefully work in this area that we wouldn't be able to explore by ourselves, separate from each other. So right now, for example, we continue to collaborate very heavily with the Rossini group on solid state NMR characterization of complex materials made in our laboratory. And we have a project going with them that is supported by the Department of Energy. We've collaborated with many other people, including engineers and device scientists, but also with people such as analytical chemists that do things like optical microscopy, such as Professor Emily Smith here at Iowa State Ames Lab, or earlier on, for example, Professor Ning Fang from Georgia State, who recently moved to Xiamen University in China, doing things like super resolution of quantum dots in different environments, for example. We have many success stories. I'm very proud to say that all of my grad students found jobs very quickly, in many cases sometimes even without a letter of recommendation. Not because I wouldn't provide it, I'll be more than happy to provide it, but they are very marketable. So because we know both small molecules and materials, they tend to have a broad range of marketability options, I would say. Some of them went to industry, some of them went to do postdocs and follow the academic path. And we even have one person at a national lab at Enroll. So one of my earliest students, Elham Tavassoli, who came from Iran, worked on quantum dot surface modification, and she's now one of the leading research scientists at Estée Lauder, a cosmetic company out of New York City. One of the more recent students, for example, Art White, is now an assistant professor in the tenure track at Cal State University, Monterey Bay, doing really well. So they've all gone to great things, and it's always great to see them succeed. in terms of living here, I really like that Ames is a small city where you can get anywhere really quickly. So I often joke with my colleagues that and competitors that work at other larger places in big cities, for example, that my commute is 7 minutes. The cost of living here is relatively low, and it's peaceful and safe. For those of us that have families, it's a great place to have kids and raise your kids and send them to school. In terms of the working environment, I really like working with students here. So we have a good mix, I would say, usually about one-to-one of international students from places like China, Sri Lanka, India, Korea, and other places. And the other half more or less comes from the US, so-called domestic students. And the domestic students come mostly from the Midwest, the upper Midwest in many cases. And I'm not from the Midwest originally, but I like working with students from the Midwest because they are usually very hardworking. They have this hard work ethic. They wake up early, come to work, want to get things done. And I find that very, that enthusiasm very, very contagious. So it's a big positive about ISU.